I'll be presenting the highlights of our 2011 non-consolidated financial statements, which cover the Airport Authority's activities here at YVR. The Airport Authority earns revenue from three main sources. The first source is aeronautical revenue in the form of landing and terminal fees, collected to recover the costs related to airline operations. This revenue amounted to $121.6 million in 2011, down from $122.8 million in 2010. In 2011, the Airport Authority introduced the Gateway Incentive Program, a five-year program that freezes total aeronautical charges at 2010 levels, regardless of actual levels of landed weight and aircraft capacity. The $1.2 million decrease in aeronautical revenue was the net result of capacity reductions from carriers that did not participate in the program. The second source is non-aeronautical revenue, which includes revenue from concessions, such as duty-free stores and car rentals, car parking, and land and terminal rents. Revenue from these sources increased to $158 million in 2011, up from $156.3 million in 2010, due mainly to the commencement of a land lease with a new tenant and an increase in contributions from the Canadian Air Transport Security Authority towards the Airport Authority's security-related capital projects. Third source of revenue is Airport Improvement Fee, or AIF. The revenue earned from the first two sources is not sufficient to cover both the cost of operating the airport and the airport's capital projects. To fund these capital projects, the Airport Authority collects the AIF. Total revenue earned from the fee in 2011 was $89.7 million, up slightly from $89.6 million in 2010. A portion of non-AIF revenue goes towards covering the cost of operating the airport, which includes salaries, wages and benefits, material supplies and services, payments in lieu of taxes and insurance. In 2011, these costs decreased to $136.1 million from $141.4 million in 2010. The decrease is mainly due to the absence of one-time costs related to the Olympic and Paralympic Winter Games and World Route Development Forum incurred in 2010. The Airport Authority also uses a portion of its revenue to pay ground lease rent to the federal government. The rent expense in the Statement of Operations amounted to $34.8 million in 2011, up from $33.2 million in 2010. The increase in rent was mainly due to a one-time adjustment in 2010, which reduced airport revenue in the calculation of ground lease. When the total cash needed to pay for capital projects during any year exceeds the amount of cash available after payment of operating costs, ground lease, and interest costs, debt financing is required. The Airport Authority takes a conservative approach to debt levels and strives to achieve a reasonable balance between debt and sources of revenue. Debt carries interest payments, which in 2011 amounted to $31.6 million, down from $32.9 million in 2010. I'll describe the changes in the Airport Authority's debt more fully in a moment. As required under generally accepted accounting principles in the Statement of Operations, the cost of capital projects is spread over the useful life of the projects, as opposed to being recognized as the cash paid each year during the project's construction. The spreading of the cost over the useful life is reflected as amortization on the Statement of Operations. Total amortization in 2011 amounted to $108.1 million, up from $106.5 million in 2010, reflecting a full year of amortization on the new projects which came into service during 2010. In 2011, the Airport Authority realized $0.2 million in dividend revenue as a result of interest earned on cash held within Vantage Airport Group, formerly YVR Airport Services. The Authority also realized $0.2 million in gains on the sale of assets no longer in use. The total excess revenue over expenses was $59.1 million in 2011, up from $56 million in 2010, due principally to the absence I mentioned earlier of the one-time costs related to the Olympics and World Route Development Forum. When we adjust our excess of revenue over expenses to a cash basis, we add back amortization, which is a non-cash expense. In 2011, the Airport Authority generated $176.1 million of cash flow prior to investment in capital projects, which is made up of the two amounts shown here, $90.6 million of net cash flow from operations plus $86.1 million net of collection costs from the AIF. During 2011, the Airport Authority invested $59.9 million in capital projects. So, as shown here, we used $59.9 million of the cash generated in the year to pay for these capital projects. This left $116.8 million in cash, which, in accordance with our financing plan, was used to pay down debt so as to minimize interest costs, leaving $66.6 million of cash available at year-end to fund capital projects in 2012 and onward. In conclusion, the Airport Authority remains financially strong and well-positioned to deal with the next phase of the airport's growth. Thank you.